Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. In this particular video, we will talk about one of the popular machine learning algorithm called KNN, K nearest neighbor, where K represents a number 1 to N. And the algorithm means that I am as good as my K neighbors. Okay, so by the end of this particular video, you will understand what is KNN and why you should make use of it. Now, before I go ahead, just a reminder, please subscribe to my YouTube channel and press the bell icon. You can also follow me on the social media. I have provided the link in the description. Okay, so let's start. Now, KNN or K nearest neighbor is a supervised learning algorithm. You know that there are three types of algorithm called supervised learning, unsupervised learning, and reinforcement learning. Reinforcement learning is sometimes also called semi-supervised learning. Now, supervised learning is of two types, classification and regression. Linear regression is regression type, and KNN is classification type. Now, just to remember that KNN can also be used for regression, but in this particular video, we will talk only about classification because that's the primary area where KNN is used. So let's go ahead and understand it. Now, to understand this particular algorithm, let's come up with a problem. Here is the problem statement. The problem statement states that let's assume that a group of people are traveling to London for a marathon. Okay. Now, let's also assume that we have the data of the participants till last year. Okay. Now, the problem states that based on the distance they traveled, guess the continent they are arriving from. Now, the problem is simple. We have to get the number of kilometers or miles they traveled, and we need to guess the continent they are coming from. Now, here is how our data looked like, which we have collected till last year. So, we have collected data from 2000 kilometer to 10,000 plus kilometer in east, west, north, south direction. Okay, so this graph is self-explanatory. Okay, now let's move further and let's try to classify the people based on the continents. Okay, now what we can do is that we can safely assume that people from 2000 to 5000 kilometer east side are coming from Europe. Now, one important thing, when I'm talking about east of London, east means if you open the Google map, right side of you will be east, left side of you will be west. Okay, this is how we can relate this. Now, again, one disclaimer that this is a totally imaginary data. It is only for learning purpose and it may not accurately represent the continents. Okay. Now, 2000 to 5000 kilometer in east side Europe, beyond that Asia, beyond that Australia, in west side, it will be either North America or South America. In north and south, within 2000 kilometer, it will still be Europe. In south, ranging from 8 to 10,000 kilometer beyond, is Africa. So this is the data which we have. Now let's try to solve our problem. What will happen that if somebody comes and asks me, please tell my continent. Okay. This is the problem we need to solve. So let's first try k equal to 1. Remember in the beginning I told you that k is a number of neighbors. K equal to 1 means find the first nearest data point, that is the person matching the distance traveled. Okay, so from the visual reference, you can see that the nearest person is in Africa and this person, okay. So, looks like things are simple. The result is that this person is from Africa or traveling from Africa. Now, what happened when we change k is equal to 2? In this case, we need to consider two nearest data points. So, let's consider two nearest data points from this person. First data point is in Africa. Also, from visually, you can see that the second nearest person is also in Africa. No issue. Both neighbors are from Africa, which means that this person is also traveling from Africa. That's the result. Now, with k equal to 2, consider this person. This person wants you to tell which continent he is traveling from. But there is a catch. This person is equidistant from the two nearest person. Both are in different continent. So you can see that person in Africa is also in equidistance. Person in North and South America is also equidistant. So what will be your choice? What will your algorithm says that whether this person belongs to or traveling from Africa or North South America? Well, there is no clear answer. You can guess it. You can generate some random number, generate some divider or something like that, and get out some value which can represent either Africa or North South America. Now, the problem is even numbers with two options are bad, because in that case, there are no clear decision points. So you can think that, okay, let's not use even number. That's a good assumption, you know. Even numbers, you will always get this problem. Even if you are getting 2, 2, 3, 3, 4, 4, what will you decide, okay? So let's not use even number for now, okay? Now let's try to solve this problem by using k equal to 3, which means that we have to consider 3 nearest data points. So from this particular picture, if you try to find the third nearest person, that third nearest person also resides in North or South America. So in this particular case, with the voting, majority wins, and that's how KNN works. If there are more than one options, the voting decides which particular neighbor it belongs to. In this particular case, this is actually belonging to North or South America. So now you understand how KNN works and why you should not use even number. You can use odd numbers, is it? Let's see one more example. In this case, it is North South America. But if some person like this asks you to find his or her continent. Now, the problem is that this person is equidistant from three neighbors. All three of them are different continent. One is in Africa, one is in North South America, one is in Europe. Now, we are back to square one. You got into the same issue even if we use odd numbers. So if you are getting into this kind of issue, that means your k value is not optimized. You have to optimize your k value based on your data set. And this is what you need to remember when you decide your k value. K, people generally randomly select 1, 2, 5, 10, 15, 20. But you have to understand that if any of your data points getting into these kind of situation, then your k value is not correct. Okay. Now, KNN is easy to implement. Okay. I will not recommend you to implement and use some machine learning algorithm library called Scikit Learn or any other library if you want to really make use of your data to find valuable information. But if you want to just try out your programming skills, this is the best algorithm to start with. If you are just learning and want to brush up your skills and see how your programming knowledge go with that, just think about implementing this algorithm. Other thing is that it takes more memory because everything has to be loaded into the memory. So there is a limitation beyond which KNN will not work. And you know, we talked about distance between two data points to consider which is the nearest neighbor. In KNN, we can use multiple ways of calculating the distance. Some of them are Euclidean distance, Hamming distance, Manhattan distance, Minkowski distance. In general, people use Euclidean distance, but you should try each one of them to see where you get the best results. So thanks a lot, guys. This is What About KNN. I hope I was able to explain the idea behind KNN algorithm in the best possible way. Please subscribe for programming, machine learning, and cloud computing videos. Thanks a lot. Thanks for watching. Good day.